Hello and welcome back to my first play. This is your Truck Simulator 2 and this music is way too loud. Let's do something about that. Play. Play music. Play music. And then it stopped. What? Don't play that stupid in-game music. That's really bad. It's better. We are going to Africa. We are now in Pierre. That is someplace, as you can see. Oops, map has gone totally bonkers. I think it's must be close to Poland. I don't know. We are trying to get to Africa, so let's find. Just 1 second. Need to see if we don't need to sleep or anything. Good map. Freight joke. We are in there. We have to find something that goes down here someplace. So let's see. This one, this goes to Brussels. I'm not very good with those names. To Kiel. Trieste. I think Trieste. That is actually a good point, because from Trieste you can go by ferry to the African countries. Yes, we take that. Trieste. It is not the most exciting goose. It's not the most new yogurt. Yes, let's do this. Set GPS. Let's get trucking. First we need to find the gear. Then we need to show them we go that way. We want to go that way. Come on. Give a trucker some room. Without load, we should not have any problem starting in 8th gear. Come on. You can do it, it's the pedal. Just press it and you go forward. That music sound a little Irish, I think, maybe. It's been a while since I last played this game. I've been playing a very buggy game called Ship City 5. It's a new game from Maxis EA, and it shows. Jesus Christ. It's a long time since I have played a game with that many bugs. It's quite horrible, actually. I didn't make any playthroughs of it because I don't think it's a game that's really good for things like that, because everything takes a very long time and there's not a lot of action. Well, there's not a lot of action in this game, but more than in SimCity 5. I see there is a lot of let's plays of the game, and that's okay. I don't want to make one. I don't have that much to say. It's 1 hour of play in that game is, well, it can be quite, I think I would be get bored if I had to look at it. Especially because there is no real action in any, there is some catastrophes, I don't know how to say that. Some accidents happen once in a while, but nothing really exciting to look at for more than 2 seconds. I really don't understand they make a game like that. They call it a sim, but it has absolutely nothing to do with simulation. Just a thing like the school system. You have 4 different kind of schools. You have grade schools, grade school, and then you have high school, and you have college, and you have university. But you actually don't need the 3 hours. You can go directly to make in a university, and that's fine. So small children start in university. That's hilariously stupid. Why are you parking here? You don't have a trailer or move it, boy. Fix the stupid AI traffic. Yeah, now he can actually run. I try to overtake. That's typical. See, there is some new map mods coming out. think I will be trying one of those. That's it. That's well, if I do that, I have to start a new character again. Because the way it is, but this game act with mods, then you cannot have more than one map mod at the time. Even though if they're not in the same area, that's you can't have. It's not possible. That is quite odd. It's incredible how fast I'm driving uphill when I'm not stepping on the gas. It's incredible how slow I drive. Those AIs. Jesus Christ. It should say slow logistica. That sign says 80. Go 80. It said 50, not 30. God damn it. Why are you slowing down? Do you want me to go out and push? This I would not do in the real world. It's very dangerous to overtake uphill. Can't figure out why they not figure out why they not fix the AI for this game. Kilometers per hour, that's simply impressive. Why are you going so slow? This really ruins the game for me. It's stupid. don't have time for this. I have to, I'll take a ticket for driving it on the wrong side of the road. It's getting night. Yes, it's very dangerous to drive over a bridge. You better slow down. Totally down. Yes. Ooh. Impressive AI performance by SCS. That was close. It's a good thing the trucks you overtake always slow down when you overtake them. That's when you want to go into the lane again, they slow down. Sometimes they nearly stop. It's funny. Another is buck. Brought to you by SCS. Kinda funny to have a traffic light out in the middle of nowhere. We can do this. Ooh. Just so BioShock came out yesterday. I haven't bought it because I don't have the money. It's quite expensive. It's not that expensive, but it's a lot of money when you have no money. So I'll be trucking to earn some money. Well, it's kind of the problem. We don't have, we don't earn money by doing this. It actually costs money because of the power to the computer and so on. So let's have some light. See, we have 7 hours to destination, 24 hours to complete this, and that was lucky. And the next rest stop in 6 hours, so we have to rest at least one time. So I think I'll do that the next time I find a rest stop. Bottom 22:50 at night. Okay, I will change lane then, when we have to. I think I will reinstall the game when I go to the new map. It's coming, there's coming a new map. I think it was Hungary, and 31st of April, of March. Don't know if it's any good yet, but let's see. It looked like there was some good roads, interesting roads to drive. And I want to try some new, I think I want to try some new truck and trailer map, truck and trailer mods, and small things. I really had hoped by this time that this year, so somebody else had made a fix for the AI, or something to make it more interesting to drive, because I think the AI really is not good for the game. It's really sad, actually. Mm. No, we don't want to fuel. Just want to rest. Oh, sleepy, sleepy. Looks like a nice road. Too bad it's gonna get ruined by stupid AI. It's a little bit funny. I really would love if there was more AI cars, different cars and so on. More exciting things, but at the same time I'm a little bit afraid of using things like that because the AI has problems enough as it is. So they actually is selling the first European truck driving game on Steam now also. There was a demo I took a look, there was somebody playing it on YouTube. I was looking at it's easy to see there are some things they just skipped in this game, in the number 2 game. That's quite funny. There's some new things in this game, but still want more. I'm excited to see when the new DLC come out for this game. They say there is one coming. Just a second. Somebody at the door. Was my stupid cat. He wanted to get in. It's very cold outside. Snow. So he's not out for that long time yet. In the summertime he's nearly out all day. Just comes in to eat. And sleep. Should be much more roads like this one in this game. This is much more fun to drive. But it's some detours you take for to come from A to B. In the case, that's nice. Chris has leveled up. I think I got the music turned down too much. Now I can't hear it at all. It's not easy to be a YouTuber. I am up to 5 subscribers now. It's wild. Thank you for that. That's the highest number I have had yet. That's quite funny. Yeah, funny. It's quite amazing. Anyone want to subscribe to my channel? I hope we will soon get some new games to play. I really hope for a good racing game or another driving game. I haven't heard of any or seen any. It's a bit sad that's genre of gaming is nearly dead for the PC. It's a really long time since there have been a good driving game. And no, the new Need for Speed is not a real driving game. It's stupendously stupid. You have no bonnet view, you have no in-gun, you don't have anything. I don't know what EA was thinking that when they gave it to those that made Burnout Paradise. Didn't they see Burnout Paradise before they said, okay, you can make our new game? I really hope they at some point look back instead of looking forward. Look back on what the game was when you started making the Need for Speed series. Then think about how good those games was and do something like that. One of my favorites is Porsche Unleashed. That was really, I think, a really good game in the Need for Speed series. The first Hot Pursuit was also quite good. I don't understand why they do go and make the game. What is going on with the speed? Jesus Christ. Slow down, man. Speed limits doesn't work when you go downhill. apparently it doesn't work when you go uphill either. That's quite funny. You're going to slow down at any point, or what? I think it's funny that you look at it, when you look at the Need for Speed series development over the years. It's just, maybe it's because that's the way a lot of gamers maybe, I don't know, want driving games to be boring and stupid. I don't know. I find it sad. I think games nowadays is too much looking at online. They're just online because they can be online. Good example is the new SimCity 5. There is absolutely no reason for it to be online when you play alone. It's hopeless. Everything, if you are in one city and you want to go to one of your other cities, if you have a big map with more cities and you want to send money or so, it takes forever for the money to get to the other city because it has to go over the EA server. And if you are a gamer and an old gamer, you know, EA and servers is really not a good idea. I've never been and will never be. I remember in the old days when I played Command & Conquer. I of course bought the game because I've always loved Command & Conquer games. Oops, speeding ticket out here. Okay. And then I had to go and use a not store-bought version, let's say that, because there was a problem in the original game. At that time, EA was starting to have their own game server for the game. And it absolutely wasn't working. So at that time, you normally you use Kali to connect games to each other. It was quite a nice little program. Don't think it exists anymore. But the good thing was that any game that had local multiplayer gaming, you could connect through Kali and then play with players on the internet. That was quite funny. And the problem was that the system EA made didn't work. You got disconnected all the time. You were in the middle of the game and then crash, server down. I tried to use Kali for the connection because I know that worked. That then the players connect directly to each other and there's no EI servers involved, and that should work, but it didn't with the original game. I was on the forums and on the forums for different online services and trying to find the problem. Then I talked to some people that was on Kali, and they used another version than the starboard version of Command & Conquer, and it worked perfectly on Kali. So I got that version too, and it played perfectly. Then I sent a mail to EA telling them about this good game they have made. It was really good and I loved it, and I bought it, and I even sent a receipt, a copy of the receipt with the mail. So they could see that I was not lying about owning the game, but I was frustrated about having to use another version than the one I bought because their servers didn't work and their original version wasn't working on Kali. I never got an answer from them, and that's just typical EA. And no service at all. Unfortunately, it's still the way EA do things. Just see all the problems there has been with SimCity 5. There's been so many problems with the servers that EA actually has given away games to say we are sorry. That was hilariously funny. Especially when those games they gave away was shit, in my opinion. Then they give SimCity 4 Deluxe Edition away. Why didn't they give people the opportunity to get the... No, I'm not going to stop here. Why didn't they give the people the chance to get the deluxe version of SimCity 5? Or one of the town or the town add-on deluxe things that you can get on a DLC? So things like that really annoy me. There was none of the other games I wanted, so just to use the free game thing, I took the SimCity 4 Deluxe Edition. That is one ugly game. But I used my free game thing. That's the whole point. I would just have loved to have the deluxe version of the... What is going on with my frames? I'm really bad. We'll be there soon. I think it may be this codec I'm using this time. I'm trying out a new codec. I'm not sure if that is... Oh, sorry! Didn't see you there, sorry. Oops. Oh no, we had an accident. Why did he go on the inside of me when I was using my turn signal? Oh no, parking trailers in rain. I'm not good at that. By the way, that is definitely not the way to do it. Come on. It's actually not that hard. Maybe it's that hard. It is that hard. Right way. Stop. T. Excellent. No damage. Okay. The damage thing is quite funny. Can't use enter. Let's get some just in time thingy. Play. Where was she going? 2, 3. Need to find 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Need to find a shop. A garage. There is one there. So we will go there. Come on. You were driving off a red light, you stupid fools. Frame today. I'm really, really low. Just need to see if we have any damage or need to have some service. 1% of the tires. That is not bad. Now we have new tires. Let's go sleep. Sleepy. On a bench. So fun if I had thrown into the wall. Yes, see you next time and have a good start. Bye bye.